गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, आई एम राजेश, स्कूल स्टूडेंट बायोलॉजिकल साइंसेस, कोजगी मंडलम, एपीएचएस चिन्न गोमपल्ले, कोजगी मंडलम, कर्नूल डिस्ट्रिक्ट। हाउ आर यू चिल्ड्रन? आई होप यू आर फाइन। चिल्ड्रन, ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे रिक्वायर न्यूट्रिएंट्स, गैसेस, लिक्विड्स एंड अदर सब्सटेंसेस फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल, फॉर देयर ग्रोथ एंड मेंटेनेंस ऑफ देयर बॉडी। And these nutrients, they should get transported to the different parts of the body, is it or not? They have to get transported to the different parts of their body. But in lower organisms or in unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium, and lower organisms like hydra, these nutrients, they need not to be transported to a longer distance through diffusion. And osmosis, the nutrients are transported within the cell. Whereas in multicellular organisms like tallest trees, sequoia, giant, as well as the eucalyptus trees, red sandalwood trees, sequoia gigantum, all such type of trees, as well as in other animals, these nutrients, water, minerals, all they have to get transported to longer distances. If only diffusion and osmosis takes place in multicellular organisms, it takes a lot of time. It takes many years for the transportation of nutrients. So to avoid the delay, a system is evolved which is known as circulatory system or the transportation system in multicellular organisms. Today we are going to discuss about the transportation system, which is also known as the circulatory system. In this, let us discuss about the external structure of the heart. So then, to see the external as well as internal structure of the heart, first of all we have to collect the fresh heart from a sheep or from a goat. We have to purchase this heart from a butcher. And we need some materials such as scalpel, blade, tray, jugs of water, forceps, as well as dissection scissors. Now we are going to do dissection. Vertical section or longer section of the heart. So while dissecting the heart, all these materials are required, which are shown on the screen. Then you have to put the heart in the tray and pour water to drain the blood that is present in the heart. Children, after that you have to insert few straws in the stumps of the heart, that is to locate the blood vessels. So after doing this, you might be knowing the external features of the heart. So what are the external features of the heart? You know that the external features are the location, size, shape, how the heart is protected, all this comes under external features. So what is the meaning of heart? Heart is the central pumping organ of the blood vascular system, and it is a highly thick-walled pulsating organ. Where it is located? It is located slightly towards the left side, in the middle of the thoracic cavity, in between the lungs. You know that there is a right lung as well as left lung. In between these two lungs, there is a space which is known as mediastinum. In the mediastinum, the heart is located. Then what about its size? Size is one's own fist. One's own fist. And the size of the heart is one's own closed fist and 5 inches long and 3.5 inches width. What is it is made up of? Heart is made up of cardiac muscle. Study of heart is called cardiology. What is shape of the heart? By seeing the heart, you can tell the shape. It is conical in shape. You can see a wider portion is seen at the anterior part and narrow portion is seen at the posterior part. At the same time, it is roughly triangular in outline. You can see here, roughly triangular in outline, and it's the beat that keeps us alive, and the shape is pear shaped. Now you can see here, a pear fruit is there. It is pear shaped. At the same time, it is made up of cardiac muscle, and you can see a special membrane is present around the heart. It is called as pericardial membrane. And it is a double layered membrane. In between these two membranes, there is a fluid around the heart. Pericardial membrane is present. It is a double layered membrane. In between the two membranes, there is a fluid, which is known as pericardial fluid, that protects the heart from the mechanical shocks and reduces the friction of the heart. At the same time, rib cage also protects the heart. 12 pairs of ribs are there. So this rib cage protects the heart. Let us discuss about the external structure of the heart. The heart is four chambered. How it is divided into four chambers? Externally, the heart is divided into four chambers by the grooves. Grooves are nothing but depressions. You can see here, depressions are there. The upper chambers are called auricles or atria. Lower chambers are called ventricles. Auricles or atria are separated from ventricles by external groove called coronary sulcus or auriculoventricular groove. Here is a groove. Auriculoventricular groove is present or coronary. Externally, ventricles are also lower chambers called ventricles. They are also separated by external groove, which is known as interventricular groove. Okay. Children, let us discuss about the internal structure of the heart. You know, children, in the internal structure of the heart, the vertical section or the longitudinal section of the heart gives a brief details about the internal structure of the heart. Children, heart is four chambers. Just now I have told. So the upper chambers are called auricles. This is auricle. This is auricle. This is right auricle and this is the left auricle. And lower chambers are called ventricles. This is right ventricle. Now I am showing you right ventricle as well as left ventricle. Children, right auricle and left auricle, both are separated by a septum. Here there is a wall inside. The wall is called as septum, plural is septae. This septum is called as interauricular septum. Auricles are separated by interauricular septum inside. Similarly, ventricles are separated by interventricular septum. Both auricles are separated from ventricles by a auriculoventricular septum. There is a horizontal groove is present. This is known as auriculoventricular septum. Anyhow, auricles are separated by interauricular septum, ventricles are separated by interventricular septum, auricles are separated from ventricles through auriculoventricular septum. To understand this concept, in the last slide, again I will show a simple diagram to understand this septum. Okay, let us discuss about the right auricle or right atrium. The right auricle is thick-walled and larger than the left auricle. The right auricle receives deoxygenated blood from the superior vena cava as well as inferior vena cava. The superior vena cava collects the deoxygenated blood from the upper parts of the body like head, neck, etc. Similarly, the inferior vena cava, which is also known as post-caval vein, it collects the deoxygenated blood from the legs as well as trunk. And similarly, around the heart, there are special veins are present that collect the deoxygenation. These are coronary veins. Coronary veins and coronary arteries are present. These coronary veins also bring the deoxygenated blood to the right auricle. So, right auricle is going to receive the deoxygenated blood from the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, coronary veins. All coronary veins together form coronary sinus. Now, you can see the opening of the superior vena cava and opening of the inferior vena cava. Now, this right auricle is going to collect the deoxygenated blood. Similarly, in the right auricle, there is a specialized tissue is present. A specialized cardiac muscle is present. The specialized cardiac muscle is known as SA node, or it is also known as the pacemaker. The pacemaker initiates the heartbeat. Actually, a pacemaker is present here. This pacemaker will initiate the heartbeat. Children, the left auricle, let us discuss about the left auricle. Left auricle is slightly smaller than the right auricle. Now you can see, left auricle is slightly smaller. And there are four openings. What are these openings? These are pulmonary veins. This left auricle always receives the oxygenated blood from four pulmonary veins. 1, 2, 3, 4. These four tubes openings are present in the left auricle. Left auricle always receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs through pulmonary veins. And the left auricle wall is slightly thinner than the right auricle. Actually, the walls of the auricles are thin when compared to ventricles, but right auricle wall is thicker than the left auricle. Let us discuss about the right ventricle. Right ventricle always receives the deoxygenated blood from the right auricle. So how does the deoxygenated blood flows into the right ventricle? Children, right auricle opens into the right ventricle through an aperture. Here an aperture is present, which is known as right auriculoventricular aperture. Simply you can remember as RAVA. So the blood flows from the right auricle to right ventricle through right auriculoventricular aperture. Aperture is nothing but a small hole. How it is guarded? How it is protected? It is protected by a wall which is known as tricuspid wall. Tricuspid means three flaps are present. Okay. So through this tricuspid wall, the blood, deoxygenated blood, flows from the right auricle to right ventricle. And this tricuspid wall is held in a position because of connective tissue, which is known as caudate tendon. You can see these straight lines, just like lines. These tissues are known as caudate tendon. Similarly, on the inner surface of the ventricles, there are some ridges are present. Now you can see the ridges. These ridges are called as columnar carniae. Columnar carniae. On the inner surface of the ventricles, there are some muscles. These muscles are called as papillary muscles. Let us discuss about the left ventricle. Left ventricle is the largest chamber. Among four chambers, it is the largest chamber. And the wall of the left ventricle is thicker than the right ventricle. Left ventricle always uses the oxygenated blood from the left auricle. Left auricle opens into the left ventricle through an aperture, which is known as left auriculoventricular aperture. So this aperture is protected or guarded by a wall which is known as mitral wall or bicuspid. Bicuspid means two flaps or two leaflets are present, then it's called as bicuspid wall. And these walls, tricuspid wall and bicuspid wall, they are held in a position due to the presence of connective tissue. Similarly, papillary muscles and columnar cornea are present on the inner surface of the ventricles. Okay. Now let us discuss about the blood vessels. A pulmonary artery arises from the right ventricle. A pulmonary arch arises. This pulmonary arch is divided into two branches. One is right pulmonary artery, the one is left pulmonary artery. Children, do you know the function of this pulmonary artery? Pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood. So your body is using the oxygenated blood, and your body parts or cells are producing the deoxygenated blood. Again, the deoxygenated flows from superior vena cava, inferior vena cava to right auricle to right ventricle to pulmonary artery to what are present in there are a pair of lungs, isn't it or not? Here, right lung as well as left lung is present. This right pulmonary artery enters into a right lung, and left pulmonary artery enters into a left lung. Already I told, in between the lungs, the heart is located. Children, these pulmonary arteries, they carry deoxygenated blood to the lungs. In the lungs, especially in the alveoli, the deoxygenated blood is converted into oxygenated blood whenever we inhale the oxygen. Now the oxygenated blood is carried by four pulmonary veins, and these veins carry the oxygenated blood to left auricle to left ventricle. From the left ventricle, a large artery arises. You can see from the left ventricle a large artery arises, which is known as systemic aorta, A-O-R-T-A, aorta, which carries oxygenated blood to all the parts of the body. Again, our body parts utilize the oxygenated blood and produces deoxygenated blood. Okay, so where does this pulmonary artery arises? It arises in the left ventricle. At the place where it gets originated, there are walls. Three semi-lunar walls or half moon shaped walls are present, which are known as pulmonary walls, which are present where the pulmonary artery originates. Similarly, where the systemic aorta originates, at that place, three semi-lunar walls are present. These are called as systemic walls. So pulmonary walls are there, systemic walls are there, tricuspid wall is present, bicuspid walls is present. Similarly, valve of Tibetius as well as valve of Eustachian is present, but in our 10th class textbook it was not given. These are the walls that are present in the heart, and the heart is a thick wall, and it is a pulsating organ and pumps the oxygenated blood to all the parts of our body through systemic aorta. I hope you have understood this internal structure of the heart and external structure. heart. Thank you.